Welcome back to True Crime News. This is your host, Ted Corner speaking. We are ordinary people trying to get crime news out to you guys, so you don't need to look through all the celebrity stuff when the only thing you're looking for is what's going on in the world of crime. Today we are making an update video on the murder case of Molly McLaren. If you missed out on our first video about the case, you find a link to it on the screen. The 25-year-old ex-boyfriend of 23-year-old Molly McLaren, who got her throat slit in a shopping center car park, has appeared in court accused of murder. Joshua Stimson is accused of attacking university student Molly McLaren in a Citroen C1 car parked at Chatham Dockside Outlet Center in Kent. He is said to have stabbed the young woman and finally slit her throat. Miss McLaren died at the scene. Mr. Stimson was arrested shortly after the attack. The pair were said to have been in a relationship at the end of last year, but Miss McLaren's Facebook page stated she was single at the time of her death. Stimson appeared at Maidstone Crown Court in Kent via video link from HMP Elmley on the Isle of Sheppey. Mr. Stimson was wearing a grey sweatshirt and jogging pants. During the brief hearing, Stimson only spoke to confirm his name. It was his first Crown Court appearance since he was charged with the murder of Molly. The family of Molly is not believed to have been in the public gallery, but emotional friends of the former sports student attended court to see her ex-boyfriend face the murder charges. Friends of Molly were seen outside the court embracing, trying to comfort each other. Miss McLaren was a student at the University of Kent in Midway. She was studying exercise, sport and health education. Molly lived in the nearby village of Cobham and worked part-time at a local pub, The Leather Bottle. Susan Tillon, the owner of The Leather Bottle pub where Molly worked, said, "A beautiful life has been taken away." She continued telling that all of her staff were so close to Molly, they have been deeply affected by her murder. And pub manager Sarah Saunders told the customers loved Molly. She was beautiful, lovely natured, kind-hearted, just perfect. Molly's heartbroken father, Douglas, said, "It goes without saying she was a wonderful daughter." Kent Online reports, Joshua Stimson is due to appear in court again on September 18th. With a trial date set for January 22nd. Until then, Mr. Stimson will remain in custody over the killing of Molly McLaren. On Saturday, close friends had paid an emotional tribute to Molly at the spot where the fitness blogger was attacked and killed. Circled around a neat pile of floral gifts, the pals were pictured holding a sunset Virgil for wonderful Molly. The case has been referred to an Independent Police Complaints Commission, which will look into Molly's contact with officers before her death. It is said Molly should have reported Mr. Stimson on other occasions. Besides her study at university, Molly was also a health and fitness blogger. Her family and friends now hope to set up the Molly McLaren Foundation by raising £300,000 to help people with eating disorders. When we receive more news about the case, we will update you with a new video, so please stay tuned if you want to follow the case. Don't miss out on all the true crime articles we share with our community. Make sure to subscribe to our other social media sites. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. We are open for constructive criticism and ideas. Let us know in the comments how we can improve our channel. Before you leave us, remember to subscribe and click the bell. See you in the next video.